Example 3 is an example that you will not be able to solve algebraically. And so we get a couple of these questions that come up. Usually these types of questions don't come up on a final exam or on quizzes and stuff like that, but it's nice to see that you can use your graphing calculator to solve questions that are really difficult like this one. So what this is basically asking is, when is cos x equal to x squared? Graphically, what that means is, when does the graph of cos x and the graph of x squared, which is a parabola, where do they meet? What are the points where they are the same? So the way that we go about solving a question like this is, using our graphing calculator, we graph cos, and we graph that into y1, and we graph x squared, and we graph that into y2. Now, what will that look like? So in y1, clear out what I have from before here. I'm going to put cos of x into y1 and x squared into y2. Now, our window most likely is probably set from something from before. And you can see sure enough right now our window is from something from before. Now, can you see where the red and the blue one intersect? This window's not that bad. Sometimes your window might be really bad that none of your graph shows up. So a couple of things that are helpful for resetting your window, just so you know how to do it. Here is your zoom button. Your zoom button allows you to see a bunch of different windows. One of the zoom buttons that you use often is zoom 6, which is standard. I'm going to show you what happens if we go zoom 6. Zoom 6 along your x-axis goes from negative 10 to 10. Along your y-axis, it goes from negative 10 to 10. So again, had we used zoom 6, you can see where the red graph and the blue graph intersect. Another zoom, so I'm going to push zoom again. Another zoom that's often helpful if you're graphing sine or cos or tan is number 7. Zoom to trig. If you click zoom to trig, what it does is it goes from negative 2 pi to 2 pi, and from negative 4 to 4. So this one too gives us a nice look at what's happening. Sometimes you pick a zoom and nothing seems to work, like when we graphed the other day, and then you have to go to your window and set your window exactly to how you want to see it. But now that we've graphed both of these, your calculator has it built into its programming for graphs to find out where two graphs intersect. You find that by pushing your second button and then your trace button, because above that it says calculate, and then you can calculate a whole bunch of things about a graph. In this case, we want to find out number 5, where do these intersect? It'll go from one curve. If you're on one curve, push enter, it hops to the second curve, you push enter, it asks you to guess, you push enter, and it will find the closest one. So we find out that one of our answers is the point 0.824.679. What are we trying to solve for here? This point that they gave us gives us an x and a y, but we're trying to solve for x. So we know that they're going to be the same when x is equal to 0.824. That's one. Oops. That was our one answer. If you want to find out where the intersection of the other one is going to be, you can go second, calculate, number 5 for intersect. And now I'm going to have to move my cursor until it's closer to the second one. Push enter on the first curve, enter on the second curve, enter to guess. Does anybody know the answer before I push enter? It's going to be negative 0.824. How did I know that? Well, could you see parabola and the graph of cos are both symmetrical? So if you had 0.824 on one side, you get negative 0.824 on the other. Well, it says to the nearest hundredth. So to the nearest hundredth, we'd have 0.82. So these calculator ones, they're not hard. But it does mean you have to be able to find out where the graphs intersect on your calculator. And so for this one, the questions you can do for practice are, number 7.